Today we are going to discuss about the digestive tract and effect of different drugs on the digestive tract system in clinical pharmacy. Non-steroidal painkiller. You know what are the non-steroidal, which is not steroid in nature, like diclofenac sodium, acyclovenac sodium, ibuprofen, methylamic acid. These are all non-steroidal painkillers, and corticoids are well known, as well as steroids separately, are well known to cause stomach ulcer. Especially when taken on an empty stomach. Bisphosphonates used in the treatment of osteoarthritis, like alendronate sodium, can cause osteophageal ulcers and are advised to be taken in an upright position. This is a very specialized drug. It's a new introduction into the market, took about 15 years, that to treat a woman with osteoporosis after the menopause stage, you know that there is a decrease of estrogen hormones in the body of a female, and there is a stoppage of the menses and menopause because of that. And estrogen is responsible for the deposition of calcium on the bone. So it's very prone, these females are very prone to osteoporosis, and initially they were treated with estrogens. But the new treatment introduced into the market with a group of the drugs known as bisphosphonates, and one of the most famous salt in bisphosphonate is alendronate sodium. But this drug is very good results with this drug, but this also causes ulcer if we are taking not in upright position with one sip of, big sip of water. This is not allowed to take with any juice, milk, and any other drinks, because if it's stuck into the oesophagus, it will cause ulcers. Diarrhea can be caused by nearly every oral drug, like iron salts. Loperamide can cause constipation, which is another drug. The liver is the site for detoxification. Liver try to remove the toxification, detoxify the drug, remove the toxic effect of the drug. Some drugs, however, affect the liver, causing serious problem. High doses of acetaminophen means paracetamol, and otherwise safe drug in normal is called liver toxicity, hepatotoxicity. If we are taking too much paracetamol, that causes hepatotoxicity in the liver toxicity. But if it goes in a normal dose, it won't harm the liver. Several first-line anti-tuberculosis drugs. You know there is a regime of 4 drugs for 6 months. Or 9 months. 6 months we call it intermittent treatment, and 9 months is a full treatment according to the recommendation of BTTA, British Thoracic Tuberculosis Association. So we give a combination of 4 drugs: isoniazid, INH, rifampicin, pyrazinamide, and ethambutol, which is not mentioned over here. These 3 drugs, because ethambutol doesn't cause liver damage, but INH, rifampicin, and pyrazinamide causes liver damage. And reduce the option for the treatment of tuberculosis in this patient. If any patient suffering from liver cirrhosis or hepatitis cannot bear these antibiotics, because it will lead to the hepatotoxicity. Amiodarone, methotrexate, and anti-cancer drugs, and valproic acids are some of other hepatotoxic drugs. These drugs should be avoided in alcoholics, and other patients who already suffered from liver disease. Dorzagliatin, an anti-diabetic medication, was withdrawn due to the liver damage. So it's easy to select a drug, but selection should be very carefully, because efficacy is acceptable, but side effect is not acceptable. Adverse effect is not acceptable. So at the time of the selection of medication for the treatment of any disease, you have to see two things: risk and benefit both. Not only the benefit, risk also. Genital and urinary tract, the drugs which affects on male and female genitalia and urinary tracts. Drugs can affect different parts of the kidney, causing a number of kidney disorders. These include glomerulonephritis, means inflammation of the glomerulus, which is present in the Bowman capsule, which may be caused by the drug like the penicillin. Penicillin is a very famous drug, very good antibiotic. And penicillin derivatives, you know, what are the penicillin derivatives? Ampicillin, amoxicillin, floxicillin, three derivatives we derive from the penicillin, which is very effective in gram-positive, against the gram-positive organism. Then NSAID, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory. Then we use gold in arthritis, lithium in depression, or suicide tendency patients, which in psychic patients, and aerolazine, which is a bronchodilator. Acute tubular necrosis caused by the drug like aminoglycosides and amphotericin B. An acute interstitial nephritis by the penicillin, NSAIDs and rifampicin. Cyclosporine and tacrolimus can cause chronic kidney failure. So you can see that we are recommending drugs for the benefit of the patient, and those drugs are causing severe side effects. So we have to be very careful while prescribing any medicine. Being a pharmacist, you must have the knowledge of all such drugs which are affecting on your kidney or other genital system, male and female. Damage to the kidney may reduce the excretion of several drugs through the urine, as these drugs may need to be avoided or may require dose adjustment. And when you change the drug, or you reduce the dose, adjust the dose. Erectile dysfunction is a side effect of the drug like thiazide diuretics and antidepressants. So now you can see here, it's interfering in your family life. So it's affecting on the male erectile dysfunction. And thiazide diuretics are the diuretics which affect on the proximal tubule of the nephron. And it has got about 14 hours duration action, less depletion of the potassium. It's not a loose diuretic like prozumide. And thiazide is used along with the beta blockers in hypertensive patients. So we have as well as antidepressants like monoamine oxidase inhibitors, like tricyclic groups, like serotonin, antidepressants. So these drugs also affect on your sexual life. Blood, some drugs affect on the blood. Drugs can produce anemia, reduce RBCs by reducing the production of the red blood cells by bone marrow, because red blood cells are producing bone marrow. Where is the bone marrow? It is present in our long bones, like our thigh bone, our leg bone, or our humerus or ulnar radius. For example, chloramphenicol is a very old drug, and this drug we used to give in typhoid. This was the only drug available in 1965, 75, 80s. This was the only drug of choice to treat the typhus. Then they have introduced ciprofloxacin, cofloxacin, and that has become the choice of typhoid. Then after that, certain period of time, in 1998, 97, 96, they have introduced another group, which is a cephalosporin group, and cefaxime and ceftriaxone. Ceftriaxone is the injectable form, and cefaxime is the oral form. It is very effective in typhoid. Then there is another drug which affects on the blood, causing a blood dyscrasia, means inhibiting the production of the RBCs in bone marrow, like sulfonamide, sulfur drug, sulfathiazide, sulfadiazine, and there are a lot of other sulfur drugs, as well as the carbamazepine. Carbamazepine is a drug which is used in epilepsy, and especially in grand mal epilepsy. There are two types of epilepsy, petit mal and grand mal. Petit mal in children and grand mal in adults. And grand mal has got all the four type of presentation. These aura stage, tonic-clonic stage, prodromal stage. Or destroying the formed red blood cells by a process called the hemolysis. For example, primaquine used in for malaria, it causes the hemolysis, breaking down of the RBCs. Penicillin is sulfonamide. Hemolysis is particularly a problem in patients with a deficiency of enzyme called the glucose 6 phosphate. This hemolysis takes place if you are giving a patient who is already glucose 6 phosphate deficient. Some drug reduce white blood cells count and increase the chances of suffering from the infection. These includes some drugs reduces the white blood cells. We call it leukopenia, and increase the chances of suffering from infection, because the WBCs have got 3-6 types of cells: eosinophil, basophil, lymphocyte, monocyte, plasma cell, and these cells are responsible for defending the body from the external organisms, bacteria and other. So if you suppress white this WBCs through methimazole, phenylbutazone, which is anti-inflammatory drug, and clozapine, which is antidepressant, then it will cause leukopenia or thrombocytopenia. Heparin has been associated with the thrombocytopenia, means decreasing the platelet, because heparin is anticoagulant. Heparin is injectable form and warfarin is in oral form. A condition that lower the platelet counts in the blood and increase the chances of bleeding. So we have seen that the drug, when we select, should be checked. What is the effect of the drug on skin? What is the effect of drug on the lungs? What is the effect of drug on digestive system? What is the effect of the drug on genital and urinary tract system? What is the effect of drug on the male and female sexual system, means reproductive system? Or what is the effect of the drug on blood? Now we'll see bone, effect of drugs on bone. Long-term use of the glucocorticoids can weaken bone, causing osteoporosis and increasing the risk of fracture. Means, for example, a patient is continuously taking corticosteroids. For example, Ventide or dexamethasone. A patient who has asthma, mostly they use corticosteroids. We give 5 milligram of dexamethasone, about 30 milligram in a day, 24 hours. And in that, if he is taking continuously this drug to overcome the asthma, maybe about a week or two, so you can calculate it for 7 days, 30 milligram, 7 days, 210 milligram. If it is continuing for 2 weeks, means 460 milligram. It's a huge quantity of corticosteroid, and that causes osteoporosis, removing the calcium from the bone. Anti-tuberculosis drugs, ethambutol, and parenzymamide can increase the blood uric acid, causing a gout-like deficit. Means a patient of tuberculosis who is taking INH, ethambutol, rifampicin, parenzymamide. We have seen, Lal, that INH, parenzymamide, and rifampicin causes some other side effects. Here we are talking about the same drug, but we have added here ethambutol with parenzymamide can increase the blood uric acid. Means uric acid level will increase. It means moving patient towards gout-like disease. Then hormonal condition, corticosteroids raise blood glucose levels and causes a diabetes-like condition. The same patient of asthma, if taking corticosteroids continuously for whole winter season, then that can lead to a diabetic-like condition, means glycosemia and glycoemia. Therefore, a history of a drug intake is important in any individual who tests positive for high blood glucose. Amiodarone and lithium can cause thyroid problem, means effect on the thyroid function. Why they lead to the hyperthyroidism? The hyperthyroidism. And lithium is used as a in the suicidal patient, depressed patient. Cancer. More hormone replacement therapy can cause breast cancer. So if you continue the hormone therapy, that can lead to breast cancer. Diethyl estilgestrol, which is present in the contraceptives, caused a vaginal adenocarcinoma in daughter of woman who took drugs during pregnancy. So fetus is also affected by such drugs. So we have seen that there are a lot of important things we have to keep in our mind before starting any treatment with any medical medicine. And we must know as a pharmacist about what consequences can happen if we are giving that. We cannot use the drug blindly. We cannot recommend these drugs blindly. This is a responsibility on the shoulder of physician and pharmacist to have an awareness about all these consequences of these drugs, and we must take a precaution and provide a full advice to a patient if he will find any such type of symptoms or any blood report from the lab that it is changing or affecting on the skin, bone, lungs, or urinary tract or kidney. Then we have to stop the treatment and we have to see that how can we help out the patient. Either we reduce the dose, either we replace the treatment or change the drug or withdraw the drug. And we cannot afford to be so negligent that the patient will suffer with our treatment. So here you go through this whole material. I am sending you this material. Read it and let me know if you find any problem to understand. And you can ask any question online. Now, for what we have discussed, we will start right from the beginning. Type of the drug induced diseases means what type of drug produce the diseases. Cardiovascular, we have discussed. Skin, we have discussed. Brain and nerves, we have discussed. Right? Lungs, we have discussed. The drugs which affect the lungs, like methotrexate, anti-cancer drug. Digestive tract, we have discussed about the non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug, which is called lungs. This postulate we have discussed, which is used to treat the osteoporosis. We discussed about the drug of genital and urinary tract, which affect on these systems. We discussed about the drugs which affect on the blood, WBCs, RBCs, and platelet. We discussed the drug which affect on the bones, and drugs which causes a cancer like hormones. So this is all about today. This is the end of the lecture.